aging skin is normal. I just want to put that out there. It is not normal for a 70-year-old person to have the skin of a 20-year-old. But what causes aging skin? Well, we like to think of it in two buckets. There are intrinsic factors and there are extrinsic factors that contribute to aging skin. We'll first start with the intrinsic factors. That's mostly our biological clock. So the fact that we're getting older ages our skin, and a lot of that is predetermined by our genetics. So if you've got a mother who had lovely skin up until the day she died, you're more likely to have lovely skin as you get older as well. Getting into the extrinsic factors of aging, the principal one being ultraviolet radiation, and that can come from sunlight, but also from the use of tanning beds. Another top one is cigarette use or smoking. And then there are other things that we often don't think about, like air pollution. Dietary choices can age our skin, and being dehydrated or actually not taking care of our skin. If we could take a look inside the skin as we get older, we would see many things happening. First, we would see that all the layers of the skin are getting thinner at a rate of about 6% per decade. We also know that we're redistributing fat as we get older, meaning that fat's going to places we don't want it to go, like our hips, and then we're losing it from places we wish we had it, like our face and the tops of our hands. We also know that we're losing the ability of collagen to turn over. Collagen is an extremely important protein that helps with the integrity, so sort of the thickness of the skin. And with that, we also have degradation or loss of the elastic recoil properties of our skin. So we don't have the same turgor or bounce of the skin as we had when we were younger. How to prevent or slow down aging is the question of the century. I would say what is paramount for slowing down the process of aging in our skin is sun protection. And so I would say from a very young age, children should be wearing sun protection in the form of sunscreen every single day. It's really important to utilize an SPF 30 or higher sunscreen, at least on their face and their neck every single day, even in the middle of winter, because there's still sun that penetrates through the clouds, as we're seeing today. The other things that we can do to help slow down the aging of the skin would be stay hydrated, make sure you're moisturizing your skin on a daily basis, limit your nicotine use. If you can quit smoking, that would be great. And then there are other things like topical products that you can use that help to slow down that aging of the skin process. Some products that I recommend to my patients who are interested in slowing down aging of the skin would be retinols or retinoids. And what those are vitamin A derivatives that increase cell turnover in the skin. And what that allows for is it kind of thickens and gives us a little bit of that turgor back of the skin. So it kind of lets the skin bounce. So all dermatologists utilize a retinol or a retinoid in their own skincare routine. And so I often encourage patients to consider using those products. You can find retinols over the counter almost anywhere. Often they're near the acne section. And there is one over-the-counter retinoid, which historically used to be a prescription medication, but now you can get one over-the-counter in the form of adapalene. Many different brands carry that, but it's nice to use. Often I tell patients to use it at nighttime, and it can cause some irritation or dryness when you first start using it, so you can combat that with the use of a moisturizer on top of it. Other products that I like patients to buy would be a vitamin C serum. This has been studied in trials in dermatology, and it's found to decrease the effects of air pollution on the skin by kind of blocking free radicals or toxins that affect the skin. It also, just like retinoids, increases the brightness we have in the skin and can, to a small degree, decrease fine lines and wrinkles and helps us to achieve a more even pigment in our skin. Aging skin is a fact of life. Be kind to your skin. Be kind to yourself. The sooner you start these skin protective measures, the better the aging skin outcome you're going to have.